Getting your house key is something really excited. The moment when you get a call from your developer telling you, oh hey, your unit is ready and please visit us to collect your key. It seems like your journey to own a place or your journey to start investing in property is happening. But that is just the start of your journey. Speaking from experience where you need to communicate with a lot of parties if you've decided to do it yourself or engage a contractor, you need to deal with someone who help you to do your defect check, someone who install your electrical, your furniture, your aircon, your kitchen, your bathroom, your flooring, and a lot more. And a DIY unit usually come with rather pure or rather simple finishing. Today I'm gonna share with you 3 tips that you will need to know so that you can upgrade your renovation game. Let's go. So first thing first, always decide your concept, your color palette, your theme before getting everyone start working on your unit. So the consistency of a certain design can keep through whole unit and you don't get a very roja outcome. If you like something pastel, always decide the color that you would like to go with. Look for 2 to 3 colors that complementing to each other and then always stick to this color until the end of the journey, which means until you do your final decoration. If you are someone who likes something bold that come with a lot of characteristics, but if you're not sure if that will suit your space, try to experiment it at one corner first. You can look for a corner and start dressing up accordingly to see how it goes. Okay, for example, if I'm someone who really into bicycle or cycling, I'll get one corner and I set up like, oh, this is my bicycle parking station, and then my bicycle tools, my wall of fame, and so on. Is there a whole house to be a bicycle theme? Because that might be too much sometimes. If you're not sure what you want, always play safe with natural color. Color like beige or gray is something good to start with, and then after that you can slowly jazz it up until you get the things that you want. Okay, the second point will be the lighting. We are at 2021 now and the light fixture industry have moved on so fast where you don't need a fluorescent tube on your ceiling anymore. That will only make your space like a hospital. One tip to start with is always use a feature light instead of a light that shines through the whole space. For example, you can use track light or hanging light, stand lamp, table lamp, and all those will create the mood and instantly change the look of your home. And one thing that you will really need to pay attention will be the light temperature. When you go and buy LED, right, there will be like daylight, warm white, warm light, and then it come with a numbers that says how many K and how many K. So there is always a theory that you can follow. When you want somewhere that is cozy before sleep, you want to relax, you can go for 3000K warm white bulb. If that space is somewhere that where you want to work, for example your study area, you can opt for light bulb at 4000K. And the last point will be the final decoration. For those who been follow our channel, you will realize how much I stress about final decoration. You know what makes difference of a house and a home? When you go into a space without any soft touches or decoration, you will feel the space is very stiff. It doesn't welcome you that much. By adding carpets, table runner, some plants, some decoration, flower pots, pillow on your sofa, that will elevate the space from house to home. That is what determines the homey feeling. And the best part is all these items is usually the low ticket value items where it doesn't cost you a lot from your pockets lah. And so remember, always put some soft touches. And I think that's all for today's video. Do you guys like this format where I share tips and tricks so that your investment journey or your renovation journey goes smoother and happier? If you guys like content like this, do like and comment and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.